my soul.
Loving you is like food to my soul.
Now then you're picking it out.
She was in the living room. And she told me to hurry up, and I yelled back, you know, I got to get my hair straight. And I heard her say, boy, you know that. And before I knew it, she was back there. And when she got back there, she shoved my head back against the wall so hard that I got a long head. It's got a lot of meat on it now. But as a little boy, a little pointed head, she shoved the point of that head through that wall, through that sheba. Oof, you know. And I went to crying, and she went to fussing. That's one thing about a woman. You know, Daddy got ready to take care of business. He would just say, I told you to be still at church. He said, we got some business to take care of. That's the end of it. You're going to hear it until you get home. Then when you get home, Daniel said, go on back there. I'll meet you back there. And we're going to take care of business. It's not going to be anything, you know, so dramatic with words. You ain't going to want to go back there no more. But it's not going to be anything dramatic with words or nothing like that. Mama was like, did I tell you every whip? And it was with whatever she got in her hand. Thank God she had something in her hand, because you didn't want her hands to hit you. But she had whatever she could find, and she was going to preach with every word, every word. One day she called us up on the school ground thing, and the one request I had was, when can we get to the house? That's all I asked. And she said, what? You going to tell me? And she whipped us all the way back to the house in front of the friends, in front of the neighbors. Everybody, praise God. But that was Mom. Amen. That was Mom. And I thank God for her, praise God. Amen. But influence. Influence. If a woman knows who she is, she doesn't have to try to be a man. She just has to know who she is and how to deal and handle her influence. Somebody say amen. The capacity to have an effect on the character, development, or behavior of someone or something. Amen. That influence, praise God, amen, is powerful. It's powerful. It's an anointing. The anointing that God puts on your life is to destroy yokes and lift burdens. Well, through influence, but you have to know where your anointing flows through. If you're out of place of where your anointing flows through, your anointing becomes ineffective. It won't effect like it's supposed to effect. Men got to know how to be men. Ladies have to know how to be ladies. Mothers have to know how to be mothers, and fathers have to know how to be fathers. It's a difference between a man and a husband. It's a difference between a woman and a wife. Somebody say amen. It's a difference between a lady and a mother. Now, do you hear me? Mothers, praise God, amen, have a special task. And their task is to influence or raise this child. And she holds in her lap the future of the world. Because a mother has touched every child in some kind of way. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Genesis 2 and 22. The woman, praise God, as we talk about her, she has come God made her in Genesis 2 and 22. He takes her from the rib of a man. About to say amen. So men, you are responsible for her. Somebody say amen. When I say that, I'm talking about men, fathers. We are responsible for our whole household. Amen. You cannot just walk off and leave. Somebody say amen. You have a responsibility. Somebody say praise God. And God's going to help you with your responsibility. Pray for the men that have left their children alone to be just raised, you know, by a single parent, praise God, amen, because we're going to come and account for it. We're going to have an account for it, amen. Proverbs 12 and 4 and also 31 says a virtuous woman, she's a crown She's a crown. Virtue there. The word virtue there meaning strength. God took strength and he hid it or covered it or protected it. Women are not weak as in weak, has no power, has no authority. Women are not weak, praise God. Amen?
Thank you.
But it says a virtuous woman, a woman that knows who she is and knows how to walk in her anointing of influence. She don't have to be loud. Amen. Amen. But she knows that she knows if you know who she is, you're going to honor and respect that. If you know who she is able to take whatever you have and multiply that. If you give her a dream, and she'll make it happen. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
You receive a dream and you give it to her. Just like you give her a seed, she can make a person come out of a seed. She can take a, turn around and take a dream, the seed of a dream, and turn around and make that thing happen. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Proverbs 14:1 says, every wise woman builds her house. As powerful as you are, you can use your mouth against yourself.
Amen.
Now, did you hear me? You can use your mouth against your own house. You can take a man and you can build him, or you can take a man and you can tear him down. Because we need, I hate to bring it down. I don't know a better word, Otis Jr. We need a cheerleader.
Amen.
Men don't do well without cheerleaders. In other words, we need somebody that believes in us.
Right.
You need to know how to work a man. He's a tool that's supposed to go forth and bring forth and bring vision and power. But you need to know how to work him with your words. I'm not talking about sexual manipulation. I'm talking about with your words. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
He can come home tore down and you can have him restored by tomorrow and ready to go back to work. Come on, somebody. How many years you got a good year, bro?
42.
Did you want to go to any of them? Did you want to go one day? Yeah. You see what? But every time they would tear him down, when he come home, Sister Mary had him ready by the next day. Y'all don't hear me. Do you hear me? Do you feel me? Amen. Amen. I'm talking about the magic of the influence of a woman. If you know who you are, then you know how to allow your anointing to flow through what the gift God has given you, which is influence. You can take a man, he can be all mismatched up in his dress and everything else. He can have on some of the craziest stuff in the world. You can either tell him the facts, or you can tell him the truth. Y'all know him. Do you? Yeah. See, the truth is, you my man, and you the only man. And so you great, you Superman, you can do anything. And you fine, you look good today to me. That's the truth. The fact is, what you got on don't match, and you need to put on something else, and that blue don't go with that brown, and this and this and this, and you can tell him how jacked up he is, and you'll break him right down. And he won't be able to bring forth and hear no vision, no nothing. Because now he's mad, uncomfortable, he's messed up, he's insecure because his woman or his wife done said he ain't right. Yes, he shut him down. How many of you men ever been shut down? If you're brave enough, raise your hand.
Come on. Understand.
So, a man don't need facts. He needs the truth. Amen. If you got a broke down old folks wagon, you wash it. It's yours. You clean it up. said, praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Amen. Know who you are. If you know who you are, you can build your house. Your house can be great because one thing you have the ability to do is multiply. You can build and multiply whatever God gives you. You can turn it into more just with your influence. Somebody say it. Thank you, Jesus. Proverbs 31:10 said, who can find a virtuous woman or a strong woman? Who can find a woman that knows who she is? See, when you're people, we take it dating and courtship and everything else. Amen. You're not looking for a date. You're looking for a wife. You're looking for a co-partner to walk through life with. Amen. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
If you go the way of the world and you're just looking for sex and you're just looking for this and you're looking for that, they'll have you with anything. But you are looking for somebody that knows who they are. You're looking for a virtuous woman. Strong woman. Able to bear a burden. Somebody say amen. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. Proverbs 31:30 says, a woman that fears the Lord shall be praised. We're talking about now, she deserves your praise because she knows and honors God. And because she knows and honors God, she knows how to honor you. Somebody say honor.
Honor.
Honor is a powerful thing, y'all. Amen. You're going to pass or fail in life depending on who you honor or dishonor. Did you hear? I said you're going to what? Pass or fail in life depending on who you honor or dishonor. Husbands and wives should honor one another. Amen. They should honor one another in their respective places. They should honor one another. Honor is the only way that you can receive. Honor is what? It's the only place that you can receive. If you have a teacher and you dishonor her, she can stand up there and teach you all day. You're not going to receive nothing. That's why you've done your children a disservice. When I hear them come up and they're going to older people, gray-haired people, yeah, no, ain't. And did you hear me? You think because we've been damaged, particularly as a people, we were damaged in the slavery institution that caused us to think, you know, I ain't never saying yes, sir, no, ma'am, and nothing to nobody else. No, listen, we were built to honor. You teach your children by exempling honor. Husband and wife, the first place your child ought to see honor is between his mom and his dad. They ought to learn honor from you. By giving them the key of honor, you have given them the ability to receive. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Honor your mother and your father all the days of your life. You know, that your life may what?
Belong.
The first blessing we have, praise God, amen, is by honoring our mothers and our fathers. That's where a child earns honor. Yes, I believe. Yes, ma'am, and no, sir, is in order because it positions your brain to receive. Yes, sir. What you say? What you talking to the elder? Say yes, sir. Mom, them used to, hey, if you're talking and you mess around, say yeah. Mom will look at you and say, what you say? That's your grandmother, or that's your granddaddy, or that's your aunt, or that's your uncle, or that's the man, that's the barber down the street. You gonna say yes, sir, and yes, ma'am. I didn't know what she was teaching me, but she was teaching me how to receive. And right now, when I have a customer come, customer be 18 years old, they come in to pay me money for the service I'm gonna do. Guess what? He is yes, sir. Because I'm going to receive that money. Amen. I'm there to receive something. I'm fixing to receive a payment for a service that I'm about to render. You are a sir or a ma'am to me. Age ain't got nothing to do with it. I honor you because you chose me. There are other people out there you could have chose. Don't disservice your children by teaching them to be disrespectful. Whew. The world's teaching them that stuff, and then you come and support it. And put a validation on it. And now you wonder why your child ain't learning. He can't learn because his mind is not in a position to do what? Receive. You receive through honor. Amen. Apostles. Yes, sir. Amen. Somebody said, praise the Lord. Amen. Amen. Why, yes, sir, the apostles? Because apostle, praise God, fathered this ministry. He placed me in place as a pastor. Amen. I'm believing that God told him that. Amen. But I'm going to be yes, sir, because as long as he's in that position, I need to receive something from him. You go to work somewhere. If that person is there to teach you, I don't care if they're older or younger than you. Yes, sir. Why? Because I'm purposely positioning my mind to receive. You cannot receive anything that you don't look up to. And guess what? I can honor you. I can honor you. And you don't even like me. But God has put you in position to give me something. You can't hold it back. God's going to get it to you. Did you hear me? You can be as racist as you want to be. If I jump on your level, we just two fussing animals in there together. But if I honor you, I'm going to look weak and I'm going to look all kind of crazy ways. All the way until down the line when I got your job. Come on, somebody. Because God's going to do something. God's going to do something. Amen. I learned to train dogs, animals, praise God, because I honored a man. See, I didn't know that. I just thought I wanted to learn how to train. My mama and daddy had taught me how to honor. So I knew how to say yes, sir, and no, ma'am, and all of that stuff. And he kept me because I was honorable. And I received everything he has and had, including his heart. Amen. You can't work for a master, what's the other word? Someone that has mastered the craft. What am I trying to think of? Expert is a word. Huh? Well, apprentice is a position of coming in there and learning. But the person is, for lack of a better word, craftsman or a... Ooh, but it's the person that loves what he's doing. They won't give what they got to anybody. And if you're dishonorable and disrespectful, they're not going to give it to you. You understand what I'm saying? They work hard at it. They want you to do it like they do it. They want you to do what? They want you to do it like they do it. And you can sit there and see all kind of better ways to do it and everything else, but it ain't your time. It's your time to learn. Where you get that? I got that from mom and dad. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Amen. So don't teach your children to dishonor. Your child has to learn how to honor. In order that he can move forward in life, or she got to move forward in life, they're going to have to learn how to receive, and you receive through honor. And they learn that from mama honoring daddy and daddy honoring mama. They watch them submit to one another. They watch them defer to one another. They watch them walk together. They watch them argue, fuss, and do whatever they do. But they watch how they honored one another. And they received that ability. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus. Honor your mother and your father, that your days might be long upon the earth. Praise God. Amen. Amen. And so, a man responsible for his children because they are his seed. He can plant his seed anywhere. I can be a farmer and I can just walk out and plant seed anywhere. Now, when you hear me complain about the roughness of the ground and that it really ain't producing, that's my fault for planting it there. Y'all didn't hear the other part of that, did you? Every woman is not a mother, but any woman can have a child. Every man is not a father, but any man can bring forth a child. Now, did you hear me? So you have to be choosing. Somebody say amen. You have to be inspecting. You have to, if a lady can't honor you, why would you give her the possibility of bearing your child? And if a man can't honor you, why would you want to put yourself in a position where you might bring forth his child? Do you hear me? All of this comes forth, this honor thing comes forth before you decide to have sex. Before you decide to get married. I counsel people all the time and they'll say, man, I can't stand his drinking. I said, was he drinking when you met him? Yeah. We both were. I said, quit complaining about it now. If God changed you, he can change him.
That's right.
Yeah, but why is it taking so long? You have to ask God. But you chose the task when you said, I do. Amen.
Amen.
You chose the task. You're selected. Don't let yourself get, don't even go on a date with a disrespectful person. If he's disrespecting his mom and his dad and his background, why would you go anywhere with him? If she's disrespectful at home to her parents and her father, and she's talking hate against them, I don't care how fine she is. Why would you go anywhere with her? Because your heart has, you can put your heart anywhere if you want it to be. And if you give it time and money and give it your secrets and your dreams, you're going to love it. I don't care if it's a fraud. You don't fall in love, you choose the love. And you choose about spending time, your talent, your money, your dreams, your aspirations. You put all that in there, you're going to love it. Won't nobody else see what you see in it, but you go, hey, I got some investments. I got some investments over here, you know? And so you're going to be there. So quit telling me you fell somewhere. You didn't fall. You chose to.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Just life and family stuff. Our families are, our world is messed up because the family, the walls have been torn down. The walls of respect and the walls of honor, they've been torn down. And we raise the disrespectful, disobedient children. And they're going to run the country. And now we all complain. Come on, somebody. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Matthew 15:28, he talks about how great this woman's faith was. Oh, woman, how great is your faith? You know that woman with the great, one of the women in the Bible had the Easter. Pressed, had the issue of blood, and you know the woman when this woman had an issue, she pressed toward the mark. It was her faith, praise God. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus. When you have a virtuous woman, she's able to press through for her family. She's able to get past all of the hiccups, the hurts, the problems, praise God. I've seen messed up men get in touch with the right woman. Come on, somebody. You're in the streets praying in the back. But if you can just find a woman that honors God, and then she began to give you honor and use her influence. Somebody said, praise the Lord. Use her influence to begin to influence you the right way. I've seen them pull them out the street. I've seen them make the bad boys be good boys. Somebody say amen. Thank you, Jesus. A man's greatest gift is a woman who knows who she is and her worth in Christ. If that's me, the word of God says, he who finds a
wife.
Come on. He has found what?
A good thing.
Amen. And gains favor from God. The woman. Ladies, do you know who you are? If you don't know who you are, amen, you can't get to where you're going. But if you know who you are and you use your influence, the word of God doesn't say the woman that finds a man, it's a he who finds a wife. You're worthy to be sought. You're worthy to be looked for. You're worthy to wait on. You're worthy of the change. Amen. If he ain't got the character, he might have everything else, but if he ain't got the character that it needs, that's worthy of you, amen, praise God, then you wait until God do the change, because you can't change that, but you can influence him towards God. Somebody say amen. Thank you, Jesus. Wait. Somebody say
wait.
They didn't wait on the Lord. They said what?
And do what?
And run and not be weary. Somebody say amen. What are you waiting on? You're waiting on God. You can have the right person in the right situation, but you can have the wrong time. And it'll mess everything up. There's got to be three legs on that stool. If all three of them ain't there, they ain't going to sit right. You need time. Somebody say amen. A man and a woman should not be unequally yoked, but vision should be the same and walk in order of their gifting to one another. Their vision should be the same. I tell my daughters, praise God, amen. I say, hey, because they're strong women, I'm going to tell you, praise God, don't marry a man without the vision, a similar vision that you have. Because if you do, it's going to be a struggle. You're not willing to give up yours. Because a wife, I'm not talking about a woman, a wife is called to lay her vision down and serve the vision of this man. You know, amen to that. Yeah, I was sounding good a minute ago. I said a wife, I didn't say a woman, so because you're a woman, doesn't mean you have to give up your dreams and aspirations. Amen. But if you can't find a man with similar dreams and aspirations, stay out of marriage. It ain't for you. A marriage doesn't make you. It doesn't make you more or less of a woman. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Amen. Now you can do more and accomplish more, because when two are walking together, they can do greater than one. But a mess can't do nothing. And when you're pulling against each other, that's a mess. You're going to have it your way. He's going to have it his way. He's going to pull. You're going to pull. And because you're strong and got influence, sometimes you're going to get a little distance. And sometimes he's going to get a little distance because he's fast. But you look out, you ain't going nowhere. Amen. Don't shout me down when I'm preaching good. Amen. And some of you wish I had a priest to you before you.
Amen.
But now, amen, you got to make it happen now. Some Somebody say amen.
Amen.
But God can change anybody, but the time it takes and the effort that it takes, you can choose your own heart. Amen. You can make this easier on yourself, or you can make it hard on yourself. So if you're a woman, if I'm a woman, I'm looking for, and I got strong vision, I'm looking for somebody with similar vision.
Right.
So I don't have to make such a great change. But if we have two different visions, I don't care how beautiful you are. That's temporary. Amen. You're going to get old. All that flesh stuff is going to wrinkle up and pass away. I don't want to bust your bubble or nothing, praise God. But, you know, Brother Simmons, they always had no gut like this. You know what I'm saying? But you, if you got to see past all that physical, and you got to find the spirit that's on the inside. And you got to learn to love that spirit. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus. Amen. And you don't want to be an adulterous woman or man. All right. Unpopular part of the message. Amen. You don't want to be with somebody you walking around town and everybody been with them. Hello? Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Amen. So now I'm saying to help that, don't you be that. That's what I'm saying. If you're a man and you're asking somebody to be something, you be something. If you're a woman and you're asking somebody to be something, you be something. Because God can take anything and clean it up. Somebody say amen. But your soul and the avenues that the enemy will attack you at, you give him ammunition to come at trying to destroy your marriage. Now, do you hear me? I hope I said that as politically correct as I can. But we all been there. Praise God. Thank God for his grace.
Amen.
But make it easier on your man. Praise God. Amen. If you want honor, be honorable. That's what I'm saying. Amen. A woman is the glory of a man. You don't need to go into a marriage trying to be the man. So you need to find a similar vision. You need to come to serve one vision. You don't need two or three different visions. We need to do one thing. What are we doing? What are we about? What we need to do this year? What we need to do today? We need to set goals and we need to walk out of them together. Somebody say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And that's how you want to walk in this powerful thing called marriage. Amen. That's how. And the woman comes in. She comes in to be the influence. It's another word that I came through with influence, praise God. Do you know when God got ready and fixed the world and made it ready for salvation, he left a woman to influence the world for him. What's her name? Her name, the Bride of Christ. Did you hear me? That's who we are. He left the spirit of a woman, the bride of Christ. That's what we're supposed to be doing. We're supposed to be as the church, as the bride of Christ. We're supposed to be influencing the world for the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. See, sometimes we can forget who we are. We're going to make somebody be saved. No, you're just supposed to influence. Amen. You're supposed to give off something. Amen. Worship, we were talking about worship last week. Worship is like a fragrance. Kendrick, it's like a fragrance. You ever walk past somebody and they had on some nice perfume? I ain't talking about one to knock you out. I'm talking about it just barely catch you. You know? And it don't slap your head around, but it go like, man, what was that? And you be one, you almost be one to follow up to go, what's that you got on? You know what I'm saying? Fragrance. That's what worship is, Apostle. It's fragrance. When the Word of God talks about the anointing oil, it begins to talk about the fragrances that went into the anointing oil. And so when the anointing was there, when they anointed you with oil, you came out smelling like God. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus. And influence there, what it does, it changes the atmosphere. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
It changes the atmosphere. So a woman should be like that in her life. She should be a sweet smelling saint. Amen.
Amen.
How she talks, how she walks, how she carries herself. Amen. She's not trying to make you, but her presence ought to change something about what's going on in the room, about who, what they're doing and what they're saying. Her presence, a woman, somebody say a woman.
A woman.
A wife fragrances her home. So that I don't care how much hell the man came through the day, he ought to be able to come in and the fragrance, the joy, the peace, the love. See, the fragrance is the fruit of the Spirit.
Amen.
When God got ready to win the world, he left a woman. She called the church. The saints of the Most High God. And everywhere we go, the Word of God says, wherever our feet tread is holy ground. It ought to be oily. I say it ought to be oily wherever you walk. It ought to be the oil of the Holy Ghost wherever you walk. Somebody said, praise the Lord. Amen. Amen. I want somebody to know, praise God, amen, that you have a husband should prepare his wife with his visions, his dream, his love, his adoration, praise God. So when she goes out, she carries that aroma with her.
Right.
And then you ought to know Sister Simmons was there. In other words, y'all know Sister Gail was dead. Y'all know, praise God, hallelujah, Sister Mary was dead. Y'all know Sister Sarita was dead. You see what I'm saying? Because there ought to be a lingering effect. Somebody say, woo, that's the word. That's the word. There ought to be a what? A lingering effect. A lingering effect. That's what worship is. That's why God gave us worship, praise God. Amen. When you worship, it saturates you with the presence of God. When you come out of it, you carry that aroma and it lingers everywhere you go that day. He's been with God. She's been with God. They said they knew, Apostle, they said they knew they had been with Jesus. They took note they had been with Jesus. Why? It was their attitude. Your attitude, praise God, leaves a lingering fragrance. Signature perfume. Don't nobody affect a place like you do. You ought to be able to walk into trouble and cause peace to come. Not by you saying or preaching or dumping your Bible, but just because they know who you are. Change ought to take place. When you get on the school bus, when you walk up to it, I expect it to be crowded. They throwing stuff in. But when you step up in there, I expect order to come.
Right.
Somebody say amen.
Amen.
The atmosphere ought to change. When God got ready to make man and put him on the earth, he built a place for him called Eden. Eden is called the place of his presence. That's the name, that's the meaning of Eden. We are built to live in the presence of God. Somebody say amen. Now, if a man understands, amen, who he is in a wife, woman, family's life, praise God, he ought to set the atmosphere so when each one of them leave out of there, they carry the aroma of that home. Somebody say glory. They carry the fragrance of that home. And that fragrance ought to change things. Wherever you go, you are here to effect a change. This is a fallen, broken world, praise God. But God is coming to take over. And he has left a woman in charge, praise God, amen, to begin to influence or affect the change. Everywhere you go, you ought to bring the aroma of worship. You're the bride of Christ. You're the womb one. You're able to reproduce. You can touch things, and you're able, if someone can come to you with a seed of hope, and you can take it and turn it into a vision. Somebody say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
It ought to change from hope to vision. From hope to vision. When a man comes in, I tell everybody, I said, man, I'd be satisfied with a shack and a little cart over in the corner and go to sleep. I don't have to have all this, praise God. But for my wife and for my children or for my family, it motivates me to go and do more. You want to do more? Get involved with family.
Amen.
Amen. Find you a wife, but don't settle for no less. Wait on you, a husband, and don't settle for less. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
If you don't find one, don't worry about it, because it's very limited. It's very rare. You don't find gold on the ground. You don't find diamonds just laying out in the street. You go get them. That would make them worthless. But you're going to have to dig. You're going to have to dig around. You're going to have to search around. You're going to have to shift around. You're going to have to shake around. You're going to have to find. You're going to have to look. Amen. Praise God. And you might find one. And if you do, you better hold on. Somebody say amen. You might find one. You mean, we got people sitting here today. They had a treasure. They found one, but they mishandled it. They mistreated it, praise God. And they said, well, it's just plenty there. They'll tell you that lie. Well, there's plenty of old fish in the sea. No, it ain't.
Not like that.
No, it ain't. When I saw Sister Simmons, I said, I knew. I said, man, I ain't going to find nobody else like her. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Amen. Look all over. Come on, you're a fool if you let, if somebody give you a jewel, God's going to give you a jewel. Put it in your presence. And just because you said, well, I ain't ready, I think I want to run around out here a little bit more. You going to take a chance on losing that? You are crazy. You got somebody you can talk to. You got somebody who can put up with your nice, nasty self. Will it do? Somebody say hallelujah. God didn't just, we say all the time, well, you know, I found the Lord. You ain't found the Lord. He came looking for you. And he looked in broken, tore up places. Because he knew what it took to produce what he needed, what he wanted, praise God. And he waited till the conditions were just right. And he came in and he touched your heart. And then he pursued you. Somebody say amen. You ever been in the party and this clown up in your face? Just all up in your face. Just all up in your face. And you just, hey man, okay, you know, I thought you were pretty cool, but you're bugging me now. You know, they just pressing. You must be trying to give away something that ain't worth nothing. Something must be wrong with you. When you read, Song of Solomon. When you read the Song of Solomon, it says the bridegroom actually pursued her. She was at the party, but he came and got right out of distance, Brother Thomas. You know how you used to do it. You don't run all up on nobody, but you're going to wait. You don't want that clown all up in your face. You don't want that one out there dropping it like it's hot. Everybody looking. You ain't looking for that. But there's somebody that's pursuing you and they see you. And every time you catch their eye, they kind of drop like they ain't looking. And then you look back over that form and they didn't move. And then you see them again. And they ain't all over the place, giving and gathering, but they keep looking at you. Then all of a sudden they go and leave and you miss them. They ain't the life of the party. But it's something about them. Jesus, amen, he just kind of walked around on the outside. And he just kind of caught the woman's eye. And then it said he was waiting on her to pursue. And he was already in pursuit of her. But he was catching her attention. If she worked, then she'll know who he is. Somebody say amen. I'm trying to teach you something now. Amen. Because you ain't looking for somebody just all out loud, dropping it like a hot. They just this and they just that. They just all over the place, praise God. They gonna always be like that. They gonna always have to be the life of the party. And you can't get in the bathroom for getting yourself ready because he in the mirror. He care more about how he look than how you look. Something wrong with that picture unless you're going to get you two or three bathrooms in the house. She want more, he want more attention than you. Come on, somebody. He left a bride. He left an influence. He left, praise God, somebody that would affect the environment. And she affects the environment not by her much say, but just by her being. Somebody say amen. Matter of fact, she's so different from the world and the party until, praise God, amen, all you got to do is just step outside and she's going to follow. Because she don't really like the party no more. Amen. Now, do you hear me? She ain't there for the party. You ain't there for the party. The party is just somewhere you are. But something has happened. When the Lord saw you, he didn't bum rush you. He sent hope around to tell you about it. Somebody say amen. He pursued you. He didn't make you. But he found you when you was broken, hurt, busted up. And he said, I care. Somebody say amen. I noticed. And you are, somebody say amen, you are somebody. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. A man's greatest gift again is a woman who knows who she is and her worth in Christ. Man and woman should not be unequally yoked, but vision should be the same. So you're pursuing vision. Don't pursue a man or a woman. Pursue vision, and whoever is supposed to be will be there. What's the vision God put in your heart? Pursue it. As you pursue it, whoever it is will be there. Did you hear what I said? Whoever it is will be there. Who God's got for you will be there. In the same vision that you're pursuing, praise God, because it's something you got to walk together in. Somebody say hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. Man, single focus, covering, provision, provider, protector, woman, detail, able to carry out many things at once. Men are single focus. We get one thing in our mind, praise God, and we're just going to do that. We'll walk over, step over, mess up a whole lot of stuff. But a woman is so detailed. My wife, hey man, she can do 9 or 10 things at one time and do it well. Man, if I try to do more than 2 things at one time, something's going to mess up. And so if you don't understand one another, if you don't understand his purpose and your purpose, you could be asking him to be like you. Why come you can't see that? Well, I can't see that. That's why I need you. If I could see all that, I wouldn't need you. I could do it myself. But I can't do it myself. I need you. Somebody say amen. I need you. I need you. I need you. I need you. Woman detail. The psalmist said he made the barren woman to be joyful mother of children. He makes the barren woman. He makes the woman who is without hope, without dream. I don't care who you are here today. You're making like, man, ain't nobody ever going to come along. Ain't nothing. Listen, God, amen, God is the one to pursue. And if you're to walk it out alone, praise God, God is more than enough. And if you're not, God got them for you. But don't be trying to force nothing that ain't supposed to be. Wait on. Come on. Wait on. Wait on. Wait on. Wait on God. Wait on God. Amen. This person of influence, some traits, they aim to help others succeed. I'm not trying to be the whole show. I'm trying to help you be more you. Amen. They are good communicators. They're able to communicate. Do you know when you communicate, amen, you show weaknesses and strengths? You don't just show your strengths, but you're willing to let someone see your weaknesses? Amen. Amen. I'm looking, you're looking for somebody that can be themselves in strength or in weakness. And they're not always, praise God, not trying to show their weakness and just show their strength. But they open up and show you everything. Somebody say amen. Amen. They know who they are. You look, a woman, amen, of influence knows who she is. She knows her strength, she knows her weakness, she knows what she can do, she knows what she can't do. You're not looking for somebody trying to be everything. They come to give. She's a giver. Somebody say amen. She's a what? She's a giver. Praise God. She's not always trying to take. She's a giver. Amen. She's humble. Humble. Humble doesn't mean weak, praise God. Humble means able to receive. I'm able to do what? I'm able to receive. They take responsibility for themselves. Number seven. They take responsibility for themselves. They're good listeners. They're good listeners. I'm looking for somebody that's able to listen. Not do all the talking. But what? Listen. They take responsibility for themselves, praise God. They don't blame other people. They take responsibility for themselves. They seek knowledge. In order for you to seek knowledge, you got to be quiet enough sometimes to receive. If you're always talking, if you're always running off in the mouth, it's going to be hard for you to receive anything. They seek knowledge. They have things as they see things further than they are. Some people look at you and see things, they see what you present. You need somebody to see what you can be. And you need somebody to push that. Somebody say amen. Amen. They believe in the vision at hand. Whatever's presented them, the vision that's presented to them, they believe this can happen. Amen. I love Sister Simmons. You know why I love Sister Simmons? I mean, she's an awesome woman. But let's face that. There's a whole lot of awesome women. There's a whole lot of awesome men. But she believed in me. Now, did you hear me? Men, you're looking for somebody that believe in you. Women, men are looking for somebody that believes in them. You got to eat that. They're looking for what? Somebody that believes in them. A whole lot of ladies lose their husbands because they quit believing the dream. Instead of encouraging the dream, they quit believing the dream. And they begin to work against the dream or the vision, trying to change it to more practical or whatever you want to call it. Now, you hear this. I'm just telling you the secret to men's heart. Again, we desperately need cheerleaders. Amen. Your husband, you're going to have to learn how to be his cheerleader. It's just the way men work. Well, I don't hear no men say amen. Y'all scared? Amen. Do you need somebody to believe in you?
Yes, sir.
Does it affect you when they believe in you?
Yes, sir.
Does it affect you when they cheer you on?
Yes, sir.
Even if you got to tell them something that needs to be changed, you need to start it first with a cheer.
Yes, sir. Amen.
I'm trying to help now. You need to start it work first with a what? A cheer. Man, I like the way you do that. You do that like nobody else can do it. Woo! I don't know what I'd do without you. You may say, man, ain't nobody gonna believe all that bitch. Man, listen, a man that's thirsty for it, he will receive it. Let him not be getting that at home. Right there. Just encourage me. Just believe. Let him not be getting that at home. And let somebody that really know how to work me and show up. She gonna lie to him. She gonna say, man, you Superman. You the greatest ever. And even he knows she lying to him, but he can't help it. Say what? Just a smile. You have to be careful around me, and praise God, because you can smile at him, they think you're trying to hit on. And all you did was just smile. How did you get that computer? Ain't nobody smiling at me. You know what the word blessing means? It means I'm glad to see you. I'm glad to see you. He needs somebody that's glad to see him. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Amen. Praise God. Because if we lose these little basic things of communication, we can lose one another. Amen. Sometimes you can get so trapped in your own world until you can't see how to encourage one another. And if we don't know purpose, then we can lose it. Amen. Jesus, praise, worship, turns God on. Did you hear me? Worship attracts God. Somebody say amen. Amen. And we are made in the image of
God.
That's right. He made us in his image. Amen. Now, men, if she's a multiplier, you would just give her a little appreciation. If you would give her some appreciation, you would get some praise back.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Somebody say, praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Amen. You go to the Lord with praise. When you leave out of that praise session with the Lord, he done downloaded so much hope in you. He done downloaded so much encouragement in you. He done downloaded so much vision in you. You'll be coming out of there, and if you don't know and understand God, you know what you come out of there thinking? Boy, I had just the most awesome idea. Now you didn't have it. God gave it to you. You know why he gave it to you? Because you spent time with him. And he poured oil on you. And you begin, this fragrance begin to arise. It is the fragrance of worship. And now when you go out of there, you're ready to influence other people for your vision. Somebody say amen. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. He deserves the glory. He deserves the honor. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. So, woman, I just want to say thank God for women. Amen. Thank God for what?
Women.
Thank God for mothers, praise God. I want to encourage you. We don't know how to treat one another and how to encourage one another so that we can be more effective. How do you, listen, man, praise will heal something. If you begin to praise, or lift up, or exalt another individual, the healing that's in them can be released. The breakthrough that's in them can be released. The vision that's in them can be released. And you will benefit from it. You'll benefit from that person because you praise them, because you lift them up, because you encourage them. That's how we're supposed to be to one another. We're supposed to help lift each other up. So happy Mother's Day. God bless you, every mother. Amen. Weary not in well doing, because I know it's hard. I see Cookie back there. When are you graduating? Where are you at in school? What year are you?
I'm a freshman.
You're a freshman? Oh, man. So
I'm entering my sophomore. I just finished my sophomore.
You just finished your sophomore year?
You just finished my freshman
year. My freshman year, and you're going into sophomore year. Praise the Lord. But you got to graduate. Luke, you haven't graduated yet? This is your junior year. I'm going to get everybody graduated. Amen. All this potential that's in here, praise God. All these great women of God. These men are crazy for running around in the street trying to find gold in the street. Do you hear me? Amen. Gold is in here. You guys are precious, praise the Lord. Amen. So be encouraged. Wait on God. Wait on God. Y'all say that with me. Wait on God. Wait on God. I don't care how long it takes. Don't settle. You're waiting on a king. You ain't looking for nobody. You're waiting on a king. And if he can't see you and appreciate you, he don't deserve you. If you gotta go find him, he don't deserve you. He's supposed to be looking. And you're so obviously a queen and a jewel, praise God, amen. The reason he ain't coming your way is because he don't want that. He wants something else. You got it? So be encouraged today. We lift you up. Every mother in here, we lift you up. I want you to stand, praise God.
It's like food to my soul. Food to my soul.